to come back here, just stick to that end.
Cool things, darling.
So I haven't got a time to take it later.
He's come out, he'd like to take it.
Beautiful beginning. Welcome to Later, and this is indeed a very special programme. All of these names are flying underneath me because they're some of the people that have been on these programmes, and it is the 75th programme. It's our birthday, ladies and gentlemen. And because it's our birthday, we have one of the most spectacular lineups a person could wish to see on British television. Who are our guests this week? All the way originally from Iceland, please welcome Bjork. One of the greatest groups of Britain of all time, quite possibly. Ian Dury and the Blockheads. Mr. Love Pants himself. From Wolverhampton, the fabulous soul of Beverly Knight. Echo Park, Los Angeles, they come from Eels. See all of these hundreds of names skimming behind me. Look, here we are. Oasis, there we are. Look, Al Green, they're all here. Everybody that you could think of. And this band we're now about to see has been on the show before. They've had a number of number one records. Why? Quite simply, because they're talented. Please welcome Manic Street Preachers.
Rabbits, then I catch it fast.
tolerate this, your children will be next. The fabulous number one song, Manic Street Preachers there, and we'll be seeing more of them later. It seems impossible, doesn't it, that Later has been a success for some 75 years. And we've done it not by clever gimmicks or funny camera angles or something like that, but quite simply by having fantastic artists and performers. The next ones you're about to see are no different to that. All the way from Los Angeles, Brit Award winners, please welcome, they're over here, they made their own backdrop, Eels. From their electroshock blues album, Eels, ladies and gentlemen. And I think I think I'd also like a round of applause for two things. The way the E, that was E there, fabulously dealt with that organ, and also the organ between his legs there, and also the fact that he did design and paint the whole backdrop. Well, he didn't. He designed the backdrop, and it was then put up there by us, because it's on the front of his record sleeve. So let's have a quick glance and a round of applause. Now let's move along. You may have seen her at the Mobile Awards. She writes her own songs, and she is indeed a great talent. We're very pleased to have with us Beverly Knight.
I made it back. From a place that had no meaning, from the wilderness of time, to the land of new beginnings, starting with the new design. Never doubted for a second that I'd do it on my own, and I held on to my gonna, trusting in the things I know. The line and what to was it? I'm the master of my fate. Coming up just wasn't easy. It took all the strength I had. Now I'm ready for the action. Mama got a brand new bed. You will never feel. Hey, you gotta love me rather than control me, baby.
Beverly Knight, and we'll be hearing more from her later. In fact, there's a lot. We've got all sorts of things on the show. We've still got Enduring, the Blockheads, all these things to come. And I'm very pleased because now we have Nikki Wire from Manic Street Preachers. Welcome. Welcome back. The last time you were on later, I think you were a bit poorly or something. What happened there?
I actually woke up the morning that we were supposed to do it for the first ever time and picked up the phone and nearly dislocated my shoulder.
Just by picking up the phone?
I did, yeah. It wasn't, of course, like no one believed me.
It wasn't like an incredible shrinking man. Have you seen that when he picks up the phone's that big?
It wasn't like that at all. It was just the tool manager gave me up out of bed and I went, oh, like that.
And you see, and that's why...
And you lot were trying to wheel me in an ambulance to get me on.
I did, anything. But that's why it's very important, if there's a musician asleep, he doesn't want to wake him up because you can do serious injury like that.
That's quite true. You should wake up naturally.
I trust the man will never work in show business again.
Or he's still here this evening. He's still here
tonight. I think he rang me in my room earlier. Now, you all grew up together in South Wales, the band. And what was the first sort of things that you all like thought, hey, this is the thing that we like?
Like just the Clash. That was it. You know, the first thing we ever liked together was seeing the Clash doing What's My Name on an old punk anniversary thing. You know, we were too young to see it. And just wanted to cross the Clash with Joy Division, really, the misery of Joy Division and the excitement of the Clash.
Mm. Also, when you first came in, you said a lot of things in the music papers, a lot of pronouncements about things that you wanted to do and what you know. Did any of them come true, do you think?
I don't know, really. We all got completely messed up. I suppose that came true.
You said you wanted to sell 26 million copies of your album and then split up.
Well, that didn't come true, did it?
Well, I didn't. And I mean, do you think there was more? What was the difference? Do you think, when Richie was still in the band and stuff like that?
I don't know. I think the mad thing about it is bands can look back at their careers and sort of feel embarrassed about it, and they can blame it on drugs and stuff, but I mean, we're all completely sober on there. That's a scary thing. We're not drinking, there's no drugs. It's just like we kind of believed it at the time, and you know, a lot of that was to do with Richie because he took it to the edge.
Mm. The strange thing is that you've been more successful since he's been missing, really, haven't you?
Yeah, I mean, that's the sad irony of it. I would have loved to have Richie here tonight. I think he would have enjoyed it a lot, but just weren't to be.
Yeah. Now, when you play for us in a few numbers' time, what number are you going to be doing for us?
I think it's a song called Tsunami, which is a Japanese word for tidal wave. And it's about these twins who grew up in West Wales and never spoke. They're very strange, and they ended up being in Broadmoor with Peter Sutcliffe and Dennis Nielsen just because they didn't speak. It's a very sad tale.
Is it true?
Yeah, they're called the Silent Twins.
Blimey. But you can't just put somebody in Broadmoor for not talking to
them. Well, they did a bit of arson as well. Oh, nothing serious. They didn't kill anyone.
I was about to go and get them out,
No, they didn't kill anyone.
Well, I think then in that case, we have to thank you very much, Ricky Wire, and we'll look forward to seeing you later on. We're looking forward to the Manic Street Preachers. Now, 75th show, and I'd like to just spin back the hours of the clock. I remember one of the best bands I ever saw was at Lewisham Odeon. And it was the band we're about to see now. I'm very pleased they're back together. They made a record 17 years ago that we all loved. It might have even been longer ago than that. They've left a bit of a gap, but now with Mr. Lovepants, they're back. We're very pleased indeed. So welcome to the show, Mr. Ian Dury and the Blockheads.
What did you learn in school today?
Jack shit!
The minute the teacher turns away.
That's it!
How many times were you truly intrigued?
Not any!
Is boredom a symptom of mental fatigue?
Not many!
When have you ever been top of the class?
Not once!
And what will you be when you're out on your ass?
A dunce!
What are your prospects of doing quite well?
Too small!
And what will you have at the very last bell? You can't bear another's beauty. You can't emulate a grace. You can't filch another's mystery. Occupy another's space. You can't take another's duty. Or take a special place in another person's history when they've sunk without a trace. What's the reward for being a bird?
A blank.
Thick as a plank and looking for work.
What a whack.
What do you think of the welfare state?
It's a fake.
And what have they handed you on a plate?
The ape.
Have you considered how lucky you are?
Well, shucks.
And what do you think of the system so far?
It sucks.
Aren't you endowed with the patience of Joe?
I wish.
And don't you feel
ready to conquer the globe. You can't steal another's beauty. You can't fill a great divide. You can't steal another's fancy. Or deflate another's sight. Not undo another's blunder. Nor pretend another's pride. You can't offer necromancy until the final hope has died. I'm a second-class person, citizen wise. This is something I must recognise. It's not my place to make complaint, but am I happy? No, I ain't. I missed my chance when I was young. Now I live below the bottom rung. I was put on earth to discover my niche. Lord, won't you make me nouveau riche? Another's mystery, occupy another's space. You can't do another's duty or take a special place in another person's history when they suck without a trace. You can't steal another's burden. You can't fill a great divide. You can't steer another's fancy. You can't take another's side. Not undo another's blunder. Nor pretend another's pride. You can't offer necromancy until the final hope has died.
Strongly recommend to all of us. Now we're going to welcome back somebody later who's been on the show before, always with a different lineup, and today she has two fabulous Spanish guitarists, Raimundo Amador and Juan Luis Arutuidez. Please welcome, with So Broken, Bjork.
Yeah.
love to Alicia and Lou. Arnson and Cannon, and
this and oh,
Army, from there, by Manic Street Preachers. Now, it's a great privilege indeed to welcome the King Blockhead himself, the great man himself, Mr. Ian Dury.
Great to have you on the show, and I mean, we'll talk about the gap of why you should have been on sooner in a moment. But I believe you've just got back from Sri Lanka. What were you doing out there?
Went out with the old firm, UNICEF, to immunise every child under 5 against polio. I went out with Robbie Williams, who's just joined UNICEF, and me and my mate Derek talked to the oldsters, and Robbie was out there with a football with all the kids, charging about, hugging people, singing that lovely song, Angels.
Yeah.
And we done, we immunised, well, they immunised 1.8 million
well,
children.
Well, I think that deserves a round of applause. That's a product, isn't it? Even better than a song. Now, I'm not sure, but is it true that recently Bob Geldof said you was dead on the wireless?
Yes, sir.
That's not right, is it?
Slightly under-researched statement, you could say. I'm still here.
Yep, you're definitely there. You're definitely there. All on full four. I'm pleased to see. Now, your first song you did was Jack Shit Jools.
Yeah.
And that paints a pretty gloomy picture of British schools. Is that were your teachers like that in the song?
Yeah. Oh yeah, yeah. And not only my teachers, other teachers. I mean, what can I say? I long ago thought you mustn't moan, and I thought, well, bollocks, I will have a moan.
Yeah, mustn't grumble.
Yeah.
Wrong.
Have a grumble.
Well, the song that you're going to do at the end is about another character, and I think it's one of my favourite songs on the Mr. Lovepants record. It's about Harry from Wembley. Could you tell us about Harry?
His poor little... Do you know that Hancock film about the rebel, the guy that's going, he becomes an artist, right? He's got the bowler out, and it's that guy. It's that poor geezer with a folded up newspaper on the train every morning. And I felt really sorry for him, and I started having a pop at him in the song. And I thought, no, it's got to be something, it's got to be a glow somewhere for this man. Then I thought, it's that rush of euphoria when Shearer puts one in the back of the net at Wembley. It's like livening his whole life up. So even though it's all regimented and kind of almost by habit and clockwork and everything, every time one goes in the back of the net, whoa, he's having
Harry, there's light for Harry. Yeah, it's not all bad.
Right up his April in Paris.
Yes, lovely. And I must say, we're looking forward to hearing that song in a moment, but before we do, I'm going to introduce somebody here. Mr. Ian Dury, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Lovepants himself. Now, let's return to this corner, where E has designed the set himself, and he's also put away the organ and picked up the guitar. Please welcome, then, Eels.
You're dead, but the world keeps spinning. Take a spin through the world you live. It's getting dark, a little too early. Are you missing the dearly bereft? Taking flight, and you could be here tomorrow. Taking flight, and you could get here tonight.
I'm gonna fly on down for the last up to this town.
What?
I'm gonna fly on down and fly away.
Well, all right. Taking a spin to the neighborhood. The neighbors scream, what you talking about? If I was not your only friend in this world, can you take me where you're going if you're never coming back?
I'm gonna fly on down for the last stop to this town.
I'm gonna fly on down and fly away.
Thank you.
Last Stop This Town from their Electroshock Blues record. We're going to move over here. I found out earlier as well that one of the two Spanish guitarists who was playing with Bjork, I pronounced his name wrong. We'll be correcting that before the end of the show. That's the kind of program we are here. Good. Let's move over here now to this corner where there's an artist who not only writes her own songs, but she must have the best voice in Wolverhampton, if not the whole of Britain. Please welcome Beverly Knight.
Good time.
from her prodigal sister LP that's out at the moment. She's also touring, you can see her. Now, I said that we were going to get the pronunciation correct, and we should do. Now, although there were 17,000 complaints when the Manic Street Preachers were on the Top of the Pops there, there'd probably be none if we didn't say this man's name right. It's not the point. Attention to detail. That's what this programme's all about. Getting the ambience nice and getting it. What is the name now, please?
Juan Meyer.
His name was Juan Meyer. It is our 75th birthday. We're very pleased to have Bjork with us. We've got all these cards because we always say to people, you know, it's great that we had you on the show, and they always write back saying it's a pleasure being had. What's been the most enjoyable moment for you on this programme? We've been on a few times, but.
I think I like probably all of them. They're all very different, weren't they? Mm.
You've been in with orchestras, with the two flamenco guitarists now.
Last time was pretty lush. Mm. I have to say last time.
Okay,
well, extremely lush.
Well, tell us about that song you played, by the way. Did you find it in Spain?
The thing is, I wrote it as a cliche, like, and then I went to Spain to record it because it was a bit of a Spanish cliche.
And then it became real.
It became real. That's what Raimundo did to it. He just took it and.
Well, you can't ask for anything more than that. Imagine if that's what you. What a marvellous man. So you just go to him with a cliche and he turns it into something of real and beauty. There you are.
Yeah, hocus pocus.
Well, we've got to work with him some more. Now, will you stay here for a little bit with us now? Because in a moment, it is a 75th birthday, so we'll be cutting a cake. And I wondered if you'd help me do that in a moment.
Yep, definitely.
Thank you very much. In the meantime, then, let's move over to this area again and please welcome Manic Street Preachers.
Things that you do.
This Is My Truth, Tell Me Yours, that's their LP. Manic Street Preachers, what a marvellous way to get the show sort of closing in its thing there. But we've got, it's 75 programmes, and two great things are going to happen here. In a moment, I'm going to become a temporary blockhead and go and join Ian over there. Before we do, could we have the... thank you very much, beautifully done. So we've got this lovely cake here, and if it was a wedding, doesn't everybody scream or something when I put the knife in? Ready? Beautiful, there we are. So I'll cut the cake. Now, what I'd like to do, which I wouldn't normally do, but it's like, have your cake and eat it. So we're going to have this cake, and I'm going to go around and thank all the bands that have been on, and I'm going to go and join the blockheads there, but I'm going to ask all of the artists here in the studio, once I've introduced them, to come over and have a bit of cake, if that's all right. I'll cut a couple of bits there, and I'd like you to be the first, as you've been on the show, what, 3-4 times now?
Yeah.
Always a pleasure.
Yep, thank you.
Right,
very much.
In the meantime, first of all, let's thank you very much, Bjork. Thank you very much, Manic Street Preachers. Hi, thank you, Eels. Some lovely people operating a camera, and I move over here. Beverly Knight, thank you very much. So now, if all of you artists, girls, boys, ladies, gentlemen, if you come over here, we'd like you to have your cake and eat it over here. This way for cake. Cake ups. And I'm going to go and move in and please, ladies and gentlemen, welcome one of the most enjoyable British bands in the world, I think we could safely say. It's an honour and a privilege to be a temporary blockhead. Please welcome Ian Dury and the Blockheads.
He's got his little white pants and he's got his little vest. He's got his little party in his hair. He's got his little trousers and he's got his little shoes. He wants a bit of Wembley at his you-know-where. He's got his little jacket, he's got his little shirt. He's got his little mochi but he's sighing. He's got his little raincoat, he's got his little hat. He wants a bit of Wembley at his eye-eye-eye. Don't call Harry a woman with data. Don't call Harry a spud. Don't call Harry a human King Edward. Harry's made of flesh and blood. He's got his little office, he's got his little chair. He's got his little cactus in his pot. He's got his little garment and he's got his little head. He wants a bit of Wembley up his you know what. He's got his little pen, he's got his little print. He's got his little policy in hand. He's got his little laptop and he's got his little pen. He wants a bit of Wembley up his Rio Grande. Don't call Harry a human potato. Don't boast him on a spike. I think Harry's a real golden wonder. Now Harry be the spud you like. Mash it up, mash it up, mash it up, Harry. Mash it up, mash it up, mash it up, Harry. Mash it up, mash it up, mash it up, Harry. Mash it up, mash it up, mash it up, mortgage and he's got his little lounge. He's got his little bit of England to defend. He's got his little garage and he's got his little car. He wants a bit of Wembley up his ponder's end. He's got his little mower, he's got his little dog. He's got his little bugger on the grass. He's got his little motor and he's got his little chopper. He wants a bit of Wembley up his Khyber Pass. Don't call Harry a human potato. Don't fry Harry tonight. Don't give Harry a chip on his shoulder. Harry's doing all right. Don't call Harry a smart. Don't call Harry a walking King Edward. Harry's made of flesh and blood. Mash it up, mash it up, mash it up, Harry. Mash it up, mash it up, mash it up, Harry. Mash it up, mash it up, mash it up, Harry. Mash it up, mash it up, mash it up, Harry. We're on our way to Wembley. We're on the Wembley way. We're on our way to Wembley. We're on the Wembley way. We're on our way to Wembley. We're on the Wembley way. We're on our way to Wembley. We're on
do is business you don't like. Sex and drugs and rock and roll. Very good indeed. Every pair of clothing ought to make you pretty. You can cut the clothing. Grey is such a pity. I should wear the clothing. I miss no Walter Mitty. See my tailor, he's called Simon. I know it's going to fit. Here's a little bit of advice. You're quite welcome. It is free. Don't do nothing that is cut price. You know what they'll make you be. They will try their tricky device, trap you with the ordinary. Get your teeth into a small slice. The cake of liberty.